Poynton lies on the edge of the Cheshire Plain between two major towns, Stockport and Macclesfield, with Manchester as Poynton's nearest city. Influenced by local industry, Poynton's coal mining transformed the agricultural hamlets into a central village. The railways and the canal system brought further development and enabled goods to be handled more economically than before. Today, it is a very different story. Since the closure of the pits and the need for faster transport, the slow canal barges are used more frequently as homes for tourists during the summer. Poynton did not change from its rural setting very easily, and farming around the small hamlets remained undisturbed through the years of the Industrial Revolution. Originally, Poynton was as a village amalgamated with other small communities, such as Worth and Midway. Today, it is very difficult to see these small hamlets due to the extensive housing development that has taken place over the past 20 years. What is certain about Poynton as a community is its ability to survive severe difficulties, which have struck everyone in Poynton. One such example was the closure of Poynton pits in 1935. To see the effect it had, we must first see why Poynton became a coal mining community in such a rural area. The early part of the 18th century saw the first coal mining in the district, yet it was in the 19th century when the greatest expansion occurred, with the increased use of machines. New pits opened, new machines were used, and more men were employed underground. Hence, Poynton as a village grew. The development of the railways network in Poynton established it as a coal mining area. This provided regular good services from the pits, which gave greater benefits from reduced costs. It was Lord Vernon who was most noted for his influence over the colliery's development. Although other families contributed, including the Worths, the Warrens and the Lees, Poynton's coal mining reputation will remain with him. In 1921, Lord Vernon retired and Poynton Collieries Limited took over control. Flooding caused serious problems for the owners, and after 14 years they were forced to close down the pits. Over 200 jobs were lost. But many went to A.V. Rose Factory, now British Aerospace, who built the Nimrod and the Hawker Siddeley 748 planes. Poynton has changed since the 1930s from a quiet rural village to a much busy, larger one. The construction of large housing estates and the industrial estate increased the population further until the number who live in Poynton is in tens of thousands. Central Poynton at Fountain Place is a reminder to people that Poynton was once a quiet village. The increased traffic flow through the village has concerned many people, and proposals for a bypass have been put forward to ease this serious problem. The modern shopping areas are along Park Lane and along Linton Road South at Queensway. This caters for most of people's needs, with a wide variety of shops available in a well-distributed area.
High Fountain Place towers the highest building in Poynton, St. George's Church, which has stood for well over 100 years. Behind the library lies the Poynton Sports Club. During the summer months, cricket and tennis, as well as bowls, are popular amongst both young and old. It is also possible to go swimming in Poynton at the Modern Sports and Leisure Centre by Poynton High School. Squash, basketball, badminton, multi-gym facilities are also available during the week or at the weekends. Poynton High School uses these facilities during the school term for its PE lessons, held once a week for each separate year in the school. Poynton children start their school lives at one of the five primary schools. After that time, most continue their education at the high school, where there is a wide choice of subjects. Mathematics and English language are compulsory subjects, English being an important subject to take because most employers demand that they have this qualification.
And off you go.
Private study is done at home, but pupils can use the junior library and the senior library during school hours. The sixth form, who use the library constantly, spend their time working or researching. However, all the sciences, a wide variety of arts and crafts, the three foreign languages, German, French and Spanish, as well as history and geography, make up a varied curriculum. The high school has seven different years. Year 1, aged 11, to year 7, aged 18, where they learn and study. School is divided into houses, between which competitions are held. Country, Vernon, Lee, Davenport and Newton houses are great rivals. Yet, when competing against other schools, everyone teams together. Day's work, students can go to clubs or take part in other activities like plays and musical productions. These have been very successful in the school. The active and varied life of the school is a reflection of the vigorous community of Poynton Village itself. In a few brief minutes, you have seen some of the many aspects of the community in Poynton.